What would be included in my common denominator? Two and x plus one. Good. Now you don't have to write it like this. Sometimes when they get big, like we'll have three of them, I like to write it. Okay, so what is the first fraction missing?
Two.
So I'm going to multiply by a two. And then let's multiply out. So I have 2 times 6 is 12 plus 10 over my common denominator, 2 times x plus 1. And then just simplify. So 22. Now when you do your denominators, don't multiply anything out. Don't distribute, don't FOIL, nothing. Leave it all factor. In factor form, sorry. Can I reduce anything?
Yes.
22 divided by 2 is 11. So final answer, 11 over x plus 1. What are our restrictions? After I find the common denominator, usually then I do the restrictions. I just forgot. So what is our restriction?
2.
Negative 1. I was very confident. But x can equal negative 1. If the number's by itself, we don't care. Only if there's a variable there, then I care about it. All right, let's try another one. Number 2. 5x over x minus, nope, plus 2, sorry. 5x over x plus 2 minus 3x minus 4 over x plus 2. Any denominators?
Mm-hmm.
No. So we can go ahead and combine them because they're already the same. So be careful because this, you need to make sure you distribute. This is where I'll see mistakes. So perhaps we'll catch them. Distribute the negative. So I have 5x minus 3x plus 4 over x plus 2. So combine like terms on the top, 2x plus 4 over x plus 2. What's our restriction here? Good. Can I simplify anything?
Yes.
What can I do on top?
Take out a 2.
Yeah, I could take out a 2 and I'm left with x plus 2. Then what cancels? The x plus 2s. So my answer is just 2. Everyone okay if we skip that So what do we have? 9x squared plus 10x squared? No, plus x squared. X is 10x squared. -27x minus 10x. -37x over x minus 10, x minus 10. So I would look at the top and see, I mean, you can think in your head, well, would this factor? And if it does factor, is it going to be one of these? If not, then you don't actually need to write it. If you want to write it, the only thing you can take out here is an x. So you're left with 10x minus 37, which doesn't factor or doesn't cancel. So this would be your answer. So just double check yourself on the top that nothing can cancel. Okay, number four. 13x over 8. Okay, so I want you to factor first, and then see if you come up with a common denominator and multiply. Factor first, and then find the common denominator and multiply. So what did you multiply the second fraction by? Good. X minus 2. Did you take note of that negative in the middle? So did you distribute a negative 5 instead of a positive 5?
Yes.
Okay, good. So on the top, 13x minus 5x plus 10. Make sure you have plus 10, not minus 10. Over x minus 3, x minus 2. That simplifies to 8x plus 10 over x minus 3, x minus 2. Can I factor anything out that would then cancel with the bottom? What can you take out of the top?
2.
A 2, so you'd be left with 4x plus 5, so nothing cancels, so I can leave it like this. How are we doing so far? First, not the denominator. go on, what can x not equal?
3, negative 3.
3,
0.
Negative 3, and 0, right? That single x, that's where that 0 comes in. So 0, positive 3, and negative 3. So what's the first fraction missing?
X plus 3.
Good, x plus 3. And the second one is missing, yeah, our single x. So I'm going to distribute the 3. 3x plus 9 plus 2x over that whole thing. So final answer, 5x. Plus 9 divided by our common denominator. Okay, number 6. How can I factor x squared plus 14x plus 49?
X plus 7 squared.
Perfect. I'm going to write out x plus 7 twice. X plus 7, x plus 7. And how about this one?
X plus 7, x minus 7.
X plus 7, x minus 7. So yesterday when we had ones like, if I had a denominator of x squared, y, and then I was doing one that had like x, y squared. How many x's would be in my common denominator?
Two.
I take the higher one. How many y's?
Two.
Also two. Okay, same thing here. It's just I don't have a single variable. I have two x plus sevens here. That means I need two in my common denominator. So I need both of these x plus sevens. And what else do I need? Yeah, an x minus 7. So if I had 4 x plus 7s in one denominator, I would need 4 in my common denominator. Although you don't usually have 4. What can x not equal?
Positive or negative 7.
Good. Okay, so what's missing on the first fraction from our common denominator? look, what's our common denominator?
X plus three x minus two.
Good. And you don't have to write out this. You don't have to do this. I just do this so we can see what's missing. Sometimes it's easier to do that. So the first fraction needs x minus two, and the second one needs x plus three. So I have, I'm going to distribute here, 2x minus 4 plus 5x plus 15 over x plus 3, x minus 2. And I'm going to go ahead and simplify that before I even put the top on. So on the bottom I have 7x plus 11 over x plus 3, x minus 2. And on the top, 1 over x plus 3. So we talked about yesterday, before we flip, let's look at our restrictions. So what are, look at the denominators. Up here, I get x cannot equal
negative
3. I already have negative 3, positive 2. Now let's flip it, because remember, we're going to get another one when we flip. So x plus 3, x minus 2, over 7x plus 11. So now I also have this. Any ideas what x cannot equal here?
Negative
11. Good. Negative 11 over 7. If you set equal to 0, subtract the 11 and divide by 7. So there's my restrictions. So now I'm looking at this. What can I cross out?
X plus 3.
Yeah, x plus 3.